Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. This is a video response to a question regarding the use of external microphones with Panasonic Lumix cameras which have the external microphone facility. So that would be the FZ100, the FZ150, the GH1 and GH2. There appears to be an opinion that you can only use Panasonic's MS1 microphone with these cameras because of the 2.5mm jack plug that's on the microphone itself. That's not the case. In fact, this particular video is being recorded using a stereo tight clip microphone adapted from 3.5mm to 2.5mm for the camera. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect other microphones to the Panasonic cameras using readily available adapters or easy to build components yourself. I want to concentrate really on the Rode video mic, which is a superb mic for use with this camera. It has adjustable gain, and again, it has a 3.5mm jack plug, which needs to be adapted down to 2.5mm to work with the camera. So I'll show you how to do that, but I'm also going to test other microphones with the camera just to give you an idea that you can really use virtually any electret condenser microphone with this camera and achieve fairly good results. This one was a yoga microphone which had internal amplifiers and a telephoto setting and an omnicardioid. I took out the amplifiers from this unit and just made it into a stereo microphone, and the results are fairly good from this. Now the amplifiers are taken out, there's far less noise. I'm also going to test this microphone unit I built for use with my Canon 550D or 60D camera, which is basically just two electret condenser microphones. Okay, let's look at the ways we adapt the 3.5mm to 2.5mm for use with the camera. If you're in the UK, the most readily available adapter is the 2.5mm stereo plug to 3.5mm stereo adapter. So this device is a 2.5mm male jack plug and a 3.5mm female socket. So the idea is this will plug into the camera and the external mic will then plug into the female socket at the end of this adapter. So here you can see the Panasonic Lumix camera with the 2.5mm to 3.5mm adapter and an external microphone plugged into the 3.5mm socket. There is a slight disadvantage using the straight connector, in as much that you're putting more mechanical strain on the camera socket, especially if you're using a heavier microphone cable. Ideally, you should isolate that mechanical stress by fastening the microphone cable to your tripod or onto the back of the camera somehow to decouple that stress. Alternatively, you can use this arrangement, which is basically a 2.5mm to 3.5mm extension cable, and again these are available by looking through the eBay retailers, and also you'll need a 3.5 to 3.5 straight connector, and again they're available from Maplin or off eBay. So the idea is the 2.5mm plug goes into the camera and you then attach your external microphone into the straight connector. So you have now effectively a 2.5 to 3.5mm connector. And in this situation, with a smaller plug and the flexible wire, you're less likely to cause any mechanical problems to the camera socket. So this would be my recommended option. If you don't like the extra mechanical connections between the 3.5mm plug of the lead and the 3.5mm plug of the microphone, then you can always cut the cable and solder on a 3.5mm stereo line socket. Again, this one was off the shelf from Maplin. So it would be a case of cutting this lead and just soldering on the three pins of the stereo socket. So we've seen how to physically connect the external microphones to the 2.5mm socket on the camera. Now let's look at the performance of the various microphones. We'll start by using the internal microphones of the camera. I'm recording this purposely in the conservatory so you can get an idea of how the ambience will affect the audio performance of each microphone. Let's start with the internal microphones then and see what the quality is like. So this is the test with the internal microphones. I'm at about 1.5 meters from the camera and in the conservatory with quite a high ambient sound and reflection. We'll now switch over to the Panasonic MS1 microphone just to give you some idea of the quality from that device. So I've now switched over to Panasonic's own MS1 microphone. Nothing's changed, the microphone level is the same, it's at level 3, and I'm still at the same distance of about 1.5 meters from the camera. I'll now switch over to the Rode video mic and we can look at the quality of the sound from that device. So this is the audio now coming from the Rode video mic. I've set it back to its factory defaults. There are some switches in the body of the microphone to change the attenuation level, but I've put those back to where the factory would leave them so you can get an idea of how this will perform straight out of the box with your Panasonic camera. I'm now going to switch over to the modified Yoga microphone and we can see the quality of the output from that device. So this is now the Yoga microphone which I removed the preamplifiers from. So it's essentially just the electric condensers wired straight into the 3.5mm plug at the end of the wire. This is now the microphone device I designed to work with the Canon 550D or 60D camera, and it's basically just two electric condenser microphones wired directly to the 3.5mm jack plug. I'm now going to attach one of the laptop microphones designed for use with your laptops and say Skype communications, and we can see the quality from this device. So this is the quality of the audio from the laptop microphone. The audio level isn't too bad, it's just about right for peaking, but we'll see the audio quality as regards to the ambience pickup. Well, that concludes the tests with external microphones on Panasonic Lumix cameras. Hope that was of interest to someone. And it's Graham saying, as usual, please rate, comment and subscribe. And I'll see you in later videos. Thanks for watching.